Howdy Neighbors, David here. And today on Boondock, Stallyns, we're going to be taking a look at Scream 5. Now, before we get started, go ahead and give this video a like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll keep pumping out more videos, theories, breakdowns, and pretty much all news and updates that I can as they come in. So, Scream 5. Now, I have been a big fan of the Scream series since its inception. I love how it likes to poke fun at itself while making each movie by having somebody in the movie break down the rules of the horror movie sequel, the horror movie trilogy, the horror movie reboot. And now, I don't know what Scream 5 is technically supposed to be. Is it a reboot? Is it a remake? And I mean, I know obviously it's another sequel, but is it going to follow the rules of the other movies? How is this going to play out? That is a little open-ended. And I would like to discuss something that Scream writer Kevin Williamson and Wes Craven had discussed while making the first three movies. Now, I know Kevin Williamson wasn't part of Scream 3 because he was off doing another movie, but he was there for Scream 4 and is now back for Scream 5. And so the idea that he and Wes Craven had was to do sort of a redux in which we would get either Sydney or Dewey or Gale being the killer in the movie. Now, originally they'd even discussed maybe Sydney's father, Neil Prescott, being the killer at one point, but Scream 4 confirmed that he was dead and gone. And I mean, it was an off-screen death, so there's always the chance of resurrection. But let's take a look at the original three killers, or I'm sorry, the original three survivors of the Scream movies. These three have probably the most likelihood and potential to be the killer in the movie. I mean, first things first, let's look at Sydney. Sydney is a victim and a survivor. She has been through trauma after trauma after trauma in this entire series, being the focal point of each individual killer that has come to take up the mantle of the Ghostface. And so she's probably got a lot on her plate, and dealing with an anniversary of that coming up, she could have herself finally snapped and become the killer. And that's theory number one. Sid is the killer. Number two, let's look at Dewey and Gale. And I don't think the two of them are killing each other or killing people as a couple. From what we've seen in the trailer, they are now separated, giving each of them their own unique motivation to be the killer in the movie. You see, if you look at it from the point of view of both of these characters, now Dewey is at home, alone, single. You see his beard growing out. He's going through the depression of losing Gale and his wife and his life and the happy existence that he had over the last few decades since the original Scream movie. And so him committing these murders could be his own twisted way of, because, I mean, first of all, you have to assume that whoever the killer is, if it's one of the three, snapped. And him getting divorced could have been his reason for snapping and being the killer, and this could be his way of reuniting with these two once again. Having said that, let's look at Gale. Gale was also, like Dewey, a suspect in each of the four previous movies that came out. That means that she, once again, gets to be a suspect in our list of suspects. And with Gale, I mean, her ambition, her drive, her need to have a story could be everything that we need for her to have snapped after leaving Dewey and having her career dried up, and she's gotten a little bit older and gone a little to seed, and maybe she's not as popular in the public eye as she used to be, and starting another series of murders would be a perfect way for her to bring back Ghostface and everybody and the murders into existence, and she could write the next definitive book, either having been the killer and found out, or being the killer and getting away with it, framing Dewey and or, oh my god, Sydney. I don't know why I wanted to call her Cindy Campbell. I'm sorry, I had a brain fart moment and was thinking about the Scary Movie series. but it could be a way to set up Sydney and either, like I said, Dewey or Gale to be the killer. And I'm to understand that Matthew Lillard is supposed to have a surprise cameo in this movie, and he could have easily survived the first Scream movie. I know she dropped the TV on him, and anybody that's ever moved a TV like that in the 90s knows those things are very heavy and could, in fact, kill him. But the glass broke, and that almost never happens. The glass is almost indestructible on old TVs like that. So it's very likely that he just got his face beat up and was put in a mental institution or something, pleaded crazy, peer pressure. God only knows what he would have taken. You saw the movie. So those are my candidates for the killer in this movie. And it's a little sad that we're making this movie now that Wes Craven is gone, and hopefully the director of the movie will take the utmost care with the story and not give us something that people didn't like Scream 3. And Scream 3 was a great movie. I love it. Even the twist that it was her brother, the killer, the whole time, and that he had a hand to play in the first movie. And so I'm really hoping that they deliver with this movie. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I am currently getting ready to make a video on this beautiful movie right here, Ghostbusters Answer the Call, the 2016 reboot to the series. I'm making a video defending all remakes. Not defending, I'm going to slam some, believe me. But I was a big fan of the Answer the Call movie, and I'd like to talk about it in a civil manner on my next video, so look out for that. Be excellent to each other, and party on, dudes.